social media. It certainly isn't the power of what passes for a media in a republic and a democracy under attack. So I want to pay tribute to every one of you, man, woman and child, for communicating with each other in your communities, in your towns, in your villages, and coming out yet again in tens of thousands to vindicate your right to water and to vindicate your right to change. Can we just get a bit of housekeeping in order? We're going to go through the stage order. It's going to be a great afternoon. We're going to have great speakers, some poetry, some musicians. Our friends over here in H&M, they'll be very, very cooperative with us all week. Can we just keep the steps of the store clear, free? Clear, please. It's a fire hazard and it's very, very important if you can cooperate with that. And as I say, the staff and the management in H&M and indeed in a lot of the stores have been very, very cooperative with us this week. So thanks very much for that. We said when we started out on this journey a year and a half ago on the 11th of October 2014, that we were going to get off our knees, that the country was under attack, and the attempts to privatise our water would be flawed in every street in Ireland. And look in front of you today, look in front of you all over Ireland, we're in a general election campaign, and for the first time ever, we have an assembly, a mass assembly of Irish citizens in the middle of an election, looking for a fair and a more equal Ireland. It's been a fantastic journey. I'm going to say more about it as the day goes on. But let's get going with the speakers. The first speaker we have is Mirren Dalton. Mirren is a trade union activist with Mandate Trade Union. Our comrades over here on the right. She helps very, very active and right to all of Wicklow. She's a young person and Mirren is going to speak to you now. Big warm welcome for Mirren Dalton.
Hi, I'm Liz Malone. It's amazing to see so many people out here today. My name's Mirren Dalton and I'm a Mandate Shop steward. I also work for Dunn Stores, New Town and Kennedy, County Wicklow, where I live. I'm here today because I want change and we have a right to change. I want a right to a better health system. I want a health minister who will give CF patients, that cystic fibrosis patients, the new drug that has been approved in Canada, approved in America, it's called Orecambi, but he won't allow it on a HSC here. I work with one of the fathers of a beautiful little boy called Mason Merrigan. He's suffering with CF. If he got this drug, he could live to 60 years of age. At the moment, his lifespan would be 30, but because our politicians want to line the pockets of the pharmaceutical companies in this country, they won't let it on a HSC. I also want a right to work. So our good old Minister for Health thinks that my friend Stephen can go out and earn money to pay for this drug, which obviously he can't because he works for Dunn Stores on a low hour, 15 hour contract, where his hours are cut every week. He doesn't know what else he's doing. Like myself, like any low earner in this country, anybody on a 0-15 hour contract, bar workers, retail workers, we're told you're late, we'll slash your hours. Where you're so sick, you didn't want to work, we'll slash your hours. We don't know where we are, we don't know where we start from one day to the next. I want union recognition. I want to work, I want 40 hours a week, I want the workers' rights in this country to be provided for the proper workers. So I say to any TD out there who wants to get elected, knock on my door, tell me that there's nothing wrong with workers' rights, and I'll give you a contract. I'll hire you into Dáil Éireann, I'll give you a 0 hour contract, you'll get no travel expenses, you'll get no lunch expenses, you'll have to make your own way into the job, there'll be no fancy car to pick you up. If you're sick, I'll cut your hours. If you're late, I'll cut your hours. If you look at me wrong, I'll cut your hours. If you say you're a member of the trade union, I'll cut your hours. And God forbid that you have to get childcare or try and get thing as childcare for low-wage workers. In all lands, and the mummies and the aunties and the grannies, they all have to bear our childcare. We can't afford childcare. How can you employ a childcare worker and you don't know what hours you're working every week? So I say that to you, TDs. You go and work in Dáil Éireann for 15 hours a week on 8.65 an hour. And then you tell me that workers' rights are all right. And you tell me that it's all right for Dunk Stores, Tesco, or anybody else who wants to ignore my union and doesn't want to come into negotiations with my union. That is perfectly fine, because it's not fine. So I'm telling everybody here today, get out and vote. It's time to take the power back out of the company's hands or put it back into the people's hands. This is our country.
Who have just left government, I don't think they'll be back in a rush, claimed in the previous government was that they had introduced trade union legislation for collective bargaining. You've just heard the state of workers' rights and trade union regulation for collective bargaining in this state after 5 years of Labour in government. Shame on them. Now I just want to be very clear on this. Come over here, you. This lady is called Siobhan. If I shout Labour, 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 you shout. If she shouts Labour, 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 call an ambulance.